It's Operation Crimson Stone Week here at Corvus Belly, and we have some epic boxes to give away. Drop your comments using the hashtag Operation Crimson Stone on YouTube, Twitter, or Facebook for your chance to win a copy of this new Infinity Code 1 Battle Pack. Good luck, and keep connected.
Hello and welcome, this is Carlos Bostre from Corvus Belli Studios, and behind the camera making this video is Connie, Super Star Wars Core Admiral, editing and caring about you all. Okay, this is the Operation Crimson Stone Week. Okay, we are right in the middle of delivering contents and making you excited about this game, and this is the video all about unit profiles for the Nomads, an army list for the Nomads in Code 1 and previous release schedule, okay? So, let's talk about this info, let's share it with you. We will try to make this video more satisfying for veteran and beginner players. Let's go into the contest right now. Let's do it. Okay, let's talk about Nomads in Code 1. Okay, and you know, veteran players, that you may notice that it's very corregidor in Code 1, really. Okay, so let's take a look at the backbone of your army, which is the light infantry, which is always necessary and always present. And let's take a look at the profiles extracted directly from the Crimson Stone booklet. So we're talking about here of the corregidor alguaciles. This is the line infantry, light infantry. With movement 4-4, close combat 14, BS 11, PH 10, willpower 13, armor value of 1, BTS value of 0. For you beginners, armor value is when a bullet hits on your tactical vest, but BTS value is when someone is trying to attack you through hacking or poisonous ammunition or electromagnetic stuff. Usually is the other alternative armor value that you will have, okay? Wounds, one wound, okay, silhouette 2, and total availability. You can take as many alguaciles as you want, okay. Equipment, none. Special skills, none. They're basic units, okay. And we have just here two slots of equipment, which is essentially the same, but they have the lieutenant option. And they cost 0 SWC and 1 point. So these are the most plain basic soldiers you can take. When the Infinity Code 1 army updates, you will see more options for these guys. But consider them your essentially order providers and tactical resource when everything else is gone, okay? You will need many of these guys in order to boost your army to the top. Moving on, let's talk about elite units now. Because we have here the intruders with heavy machine gun, and this guy is a classic Infinity unit, and you will love him just because has certain devices and certain equipment with him. Let's take a look at his values. He's a medium infantry with movement 4-4, close combat 14, BS 13, PH value of 12, willpower 14, armor 3, which is pretty nice, BTS 0, 1 wound, availability of 2. Okay, the cool thing about these guys is that they have multi-spectral visor level 2, so they can see through smoke, and they can nullify the mimetism value of any enemy troop. And they are carrying a heavy machine gun, which is a high burst weapon with a damage value of 15 and a burst value of 4. So when you're rolling 4 dice against enemies, usually in active turn you will be deadly. And in reactive turn, you cannot be cheated by any little trick of smoke and stuff like that. So they become suddenly a very, very, very trustworthy unit for you. 1.5 SWC and 4 points, which is kind of pricey in Code 1, but believe me, these guys usually dominate from a sniper tower, okay, the table, okay. Moving on, let's talk about the Hellcats, which are a classic paratroopers from the Nomads, okay, and this can make combat jump, and also have the parachutist skill, so they can both descend into the table with a roll wherever they want, or just enter through from one side of the table, except the deployment area or the enemy. But very, very reliable assault units, units that you will throw over your enemy. Okay, medium infantry, regular, movement 4-4, close combat 14, BS 12, PH 12, willpower 13, armor value of 2, BTS value of 3, one wound, and availability of 4. You can take many of these guys. Okay. The one that comes in the Operation Crimson Stone is with the boarding shotgun. So it's a close combat weapon, okay, a weapon for close range. So descend very close to the enemy, turn around the corner, and blast them with the shotgun. Is their role in the battlefield, and they accomplish that very efficiently. Okay, so trust these guys in order to throw them like rocks on the face of your rival. Okay, so moving on, let's take a look at more profiles. Okay, Sombras, your skirmisher, your infiltrator here. Medium infantry, regular, movement 4-4, close combat 15, BS 12, PH 11, willpower 13, armor value of 3, BTS value of 6, pretty high. One wound, availability of 1, very special unit, okay. Special skills, lots of them. Camouflage, the ability to become a camo marker on the board, okay. Climbing plus, the ability to walk on vertical surfaces like they are horizontal surfaces, very useful. Forward deployment plus 2 inches. It's not infiltration, it's forward deployment plus 8 inches, okay. 8 inches, so really nice. Mimetism minus 3, this ability puts a minus 3 on the ballistic skill or discover roll of any enemy that tries to discover or shoot at you. Very, very useful. And surprise attack minus 3. Every time you pop up from the marker state to the miniature state, you are surprising the enemy and you make them suffer an additional minus 3 to the reaction roll. Doesn't matter if they shoot back or they dodge, they will suffer a minus 3. Sombra in the Operation Crimson Stone box is also hacker. It's coming with a hacking device and multi-rifle and light shotgun, so plenty of stuff. Pistol, close combat weapon, 0.5 SW special weapon cost, and 3.5 cost. So pricey, I don't think so. I think this is a very, very accurate price for such a unit that can accomplish so many things. So congratulations, Nomads, for receiving a Sombras in the box. Moving on, Evaders, EVA Tactical Group, probably the most cool-looking figure of the box. Post that in the comments if you agree, okay. Heavy infantry, okay, regular, hackable, okay. Movement 4-4, close combat 15, BS 13, nice. PH 12, willpower 13, armor and BTS both 3, okay. One wound, silhouette 2, one availability of 1. No equipment, but climbing plus and specialist operative. Evader is carrying the Spitfire, which is a very, very decent weapon, pistol and close combat weapon, 1.5 SWC and 2.5 cost. Really nice, really nice. I mean, really nice miniature, really nice unit profile, not especially pricey, 2.5, I think is really fine. So these are the Nomad units from Operation Crimson Stone, and now let's take a look at the special figures that comes in the bundle. Because we have here Wolfgang Amadeus Wall, the Wolfgang Bounty Hunter, that is both playable in Ariadna and Nomads. Let's check out his profile. Warband, movement 4-4, close combat 22, BS 12, PS 14, willpower 13, armor and BTS both 3, 2 wounds, which is something special, martial arts level 3, high, dodge plus 1 inch, dodge plus 3, so rolling with a 17 of PH roll when dodging, and if he succeeds, he can move up to 3 inches, not the usual 2. Climbing plus, so the ability to walk up this wall like nothing, okay. And carrying a multi-rifle with plus 1 burst, and chain call, which is a template weapon, with a heavy pistol, with a double action close combat weapon, with a para minus 6 close combat weapon, just for 3 points and 0 SWC. Very good unit. Especially for a beginner player, this guy can do all kinds of tricks, so really nice. And apart from that, there's this Dire Foes mission pack, Xanadu Rush, that comes with Billy and Jazz, okay? And this is especially incredible because if you put together all the figures from Operation Crimson Stone and the bundle, you will end up having a whole combat group because there are 10 miniatures. So let's take a look at the Jasmine Jazz, Katy Kovas, Tactical Hacker, and Billy Customized Support Remote unit profiles. Okay, light infantry, regular and hackable, okay? With movement of 4-4, close combat of 16, BS of 11, PH 10, willpower 14, armor of 0, BTS of 6, totally the opposite stuff of usual troops, 1 wound and availability of 1 because obviously it's a character. Equipment, hacker device, okay, no special skills, just hacker with submachine gun and anti-personal mines, pistol and para minus 3, close combat weapon, 0.5, 1.5 cost, okay, and her remote, which is something that comes with her, cannot be aligned independently, okay, but is an independent figure on the board, okay. Billy, remote, regular, Moomino 6-4, Close Combat 13, BS-10, PH-10, Willpower 13, Arm 0, BTS-3, Structure, not Wounds, Structure 1, Availability of 1, obviously, Equipment Repeater, he can expand the area of influence of Jazz, okay, or any other hacker, Special Skills, Remote Presence, Courage, and Shock Immunity. Billy, Anti-Personal Mines, Pistol para minus 3 Close Combat Weapon, just for 0.5 points of cost, okay? Billy cannot be filled if just hacker is not in the army list, okay? So this couple brings the hacker thing to the board, and apart from that, you also have another hacker with the Sombras. With the Sombras, right? Did I say that correctly? Yep, the Sombras, yeah, correctly. So, hackers in the board of any kind of Operation Code 1 list with the Nomads. So those are the units that are for you. Shall we take a look at the army list of the Nomads? Let's do it. Looking at the army list of the chosen units of these armies are very revealing, especially not only for beginner players but also veteran players that will know which units are Scorbus Belli going to focus in the next following ones, as the release schedule is also an opportunity for sculpting central models. So let's take a look at the chosen units for the Nomads Code 1 army list. Corregidor Aguaciles, okay. Tomcats, which is another kind of paratroopers here. Hellcats, the classical paratroopers. Grenzers, Grand Security Team, Elite Snipers usually, very useful. Wildcats, Polyvalent Tactical Unit, okay, so just by looking at this we know which kind of miniatures this Corvus Belli going to release. Intruders, comes in the box. Sombras, we have just seen them, comes in the box. Evaders, one of the stars of the box, obviously. Mobile Brigada, the classical heavy infantry from Corregidor. Chrysaborax, okay, these are ones from Tunguska, these are Silhouette 5 heavy infantry, very massive, okay. Taskmasters, the same thing but from Bakunin, okay, I don't know if you understand me, beginner players, but these are very big heavy infantry for the other sectoral armies of the Nomads, which are not Corregidor, but mostly of this unit are all from Corregidor. Salamander Squad, so now we know the tag that is going to be deployed in the Code 1 tables is the Salamander, one of the most impressive miniatures that Corvus Belli has ever produced, really. Now let's take a look at the support units. Dactaris, Clockmakers, Sombots on the bottom of the list. These will be together in the Nomads support pack, and they are going to all to be new miniatures, okay, I can tell you that. Let's take a look at the remotes. Bostock Sputniks, Stemper Zones, Reaction Zones, Vertigo Zones, Transductor Zones, and Meteor Zones, okay? So, the Stemper, Reaction, Vertigo, and Transductor are the new zones. They will come together in a box in a new, upcoming, lovely, redesigned 3D models of the basic remotes for Nomads. But having here in the list the Meteor Zones is very promising because it's a classic, very spectacular Nomad unit because it's a remote that can make combat jump, it's something very special. And the Vostok Sputnik is one of the more recent additions to the Nomads remotes because it's a totally armored platform, okay, very super destroying remote, very dangerous. And if we take a look at the heroes here, we can see Jazz and Billy, Tactical Hacking Team, Many Problems, Tactical Overhyper, Perseus, Rogue Myrmidon, okay, the Myrmidon made in 3D that even Aleph can have, okay, and Wolfgang Amadeus Wolf, the hero, the Wolverine Hunter that comes in the pre-order exclusive of Operation Crimson Stone. These are the chosen units for Nomads in Code 1. And finally, a little note here, not only for beginners but also for veterans, the release schedule for Nomads for the rest of 2021, okay? I can share with you that August is the month that we will provide and release Operation Crimson Stone and also the Dire Foes Xanadu Rush mission pack. So suddenly a Code 1 player has already one combat group with the bundle, okay, with 10 figures, okay? And later, in September, we are going to release the natural expansion of this box that will be beyond Crimson Stone and is going to have 3 against 3 more Ariadna and Nomads figures. And which are the Nomad ones? The Nomads that will come in beyond Crimson Stone are a Tomcat new 3D model, okay, totally new and scoped and redesigned 3D model that will cover the Engineer with multi-rifle option, okay, Apart from that, we have the Vostok Sputnik is coming in the Beyond Crimson Stone. It's the biggest figure from the box. It's the big remote, demolishing remote of the Nomads. And finally, Wildcat. Also, Wildcat's being redesigned and resculpted in 3D with the Spitfire loadout. So packing a lot of punch for the Nomads in Beyond Crimson Stone. Moving on, for October, we will release a new support pack with Dactaris, Clockmaker, and Zombots, okay, all redesigned and new from in 3D. Lovely, I have just seen the design, they are going to be lovely for Nomads. So new support pack for beginners and veterans, okay, lovely, new Dactaris and Clockmakers. And for November, yes, the remotes, okay, new box of remotes, the Sun remotes for Nomads. They have waiting for this since 2009, I guess. It's a pretty old SKU from Corvus Belli classical units, and we're making them new, and they're going to be lovely because we're putting a lot of love in this. Nobody complained in Pano or Yuching when we released the new Dronebots and Jaokongs, so now it's happening for the Nomads. Congratulations, Nomads, okay? And that will be the rest of the year for Nomads from Corvus Belli for Code 1 and M4. This has been the unit profiles and release schedule and army list video from Operation Crimson Stone for the Nomads. Thank you so much for your attention. Drop your comments below, like and subscribe, the usual stuff from the YouTube channels, okay? Tell us what you think, tell us what you are most looking forward to. Wait during the week and during the pre-order because Corvus Belli will give you previews of many of the models we have been mentioning. Thank you so much for your attention. Bye!